The Keck Institute for Space Studies is funding us to do a program of development of a new type of astronomical detector, which is a kind of a transistor. These detectors will be used on a very wide variety of astronomical instruments, radio telescopes all over the world, lots of satellites. I mean, it's going to have a huge impact and actually, I think, bring about a complete revolution of radio astronomy.
In the same way that interferometers, which, say, take one of the best-known examples, the Very Large Array in New Mexico, have changed the way that we observe the radio sky, have shown us things that were impossible to see before. So we're talking about the same kind of change in how rapidly and how many things we can look at.
Astronomical objects radiate over a very large range of wavelengths or frequencies, and with the optical, you're looking at only a very tiny portion of that whole range. So there are many, many astronomical objects that you can see very clearly in the radio that cannot be seen at all or only dimly in the optical. So, for example, the cosmic microwave background radiation, radiation left over from the Big Bang, it's showing us the earliest signal that we can see in the universe, and you cannot see it optically at all. You have to observe it with radio frequencies.
The holy grail of this field is to measure the B-mode polarization of the cosmic microwave background, and that's the signature of this very rapid expansion that took place in the earliest moments of the universe. To do this, to measure this fantastically faint signal, we need to fundamentally improve the performance of the amplifiers that we use to detect the signal. Today, the performance of the amplifiers is about 10 times their fundamental limit, known as the quantum limit, and we hope to push that down to about 3 times the quantum limit, and to put these new amplifiers into very miniaturized packages, and to take these packages and array them, to have many hundreds of them at the focal plane of a single telescope. And the combination of those two approaches, improving the fundamental performance and arraying the detectors, will hopefully allow us to measure this B-mode signature.
The designs are done up at JPL. These designs are then sent to Northrop Grumman. These transistors are then produced on what we call wafers, which are typically a wafer would be maybe about a 4-inch diameter disc. And on that wafer, depending on exactly what you have on the wafer, you could have anywhere between a few hundred to a few thousand of these transistors.
This is one half of a typical wafer. It's actually smaller than the wafers we will be measuring in that probe station. And you can see there are many, many small repeating patterns, and each one of those is an individual circuit. It may be an amplifier or something else.
The idea is we'll take one of these wafers and place it in the probe station, and then those two pronged connections, we will land each one of those on one of those devices very carefully, because everything's very, very delicate.
So we've got this critical wafer measurement capability on the campus here. We've got a couple of things with design amplifiers and modules at JPL and Northrop Grumman primarily building the wafers.
So the signals we're trying to measure are fantastically faint, and the sensitivity of these amplifiers gets better and better as you cool them down. So radio astronomers are the only people who need to operate these devices at these such fantastically low temperatures. All the other commercial uses, they can work at room temperature, so we're the only people who need to cool these devices down.
So there are two threads to the program. We're trying to make individual detectors better and get down right as close as we possibly can to fundamental physical limits, things that say, this is the best it can possibly be. And we also want to make things bigger. So bigger and better is what we're after. So if we have a single detector, we can look at one spot in the sky. And what we want to do is, well, just like with a camera, more pixels are better. We want to be able to make many, many detector elements. We want to make them so that we can put them all together, observe a larger field at one time.
If we're successful in this program, if we can actually push the noise of these amplifiers from 10 times our quantum limit down to 3 times our quantum limit, then this could revolutionize the field of radio astronomy. These amplifiers could end up in every radio telescope observing at these frequencies in the world, not only on radio astronomy in general, but also the specific field of CMB polarization.